Good morning, students. This is the fourth online class we are conducting on the fluid mechanics class. So I will quickly repeat the things which we have discussed in the last three classes. In the very first class, we have discussed whatever basic principles we are using in the analysis of fluid mechanics. Those three basic physical laws are the principles, are the law of conservation of mass, law of conservation of momentum, and law of conservation of energy. So based on these three basic principles, we are analyzing the fluid from the engineering point of view or for the engineering applications. Then we have discussed the various types of fluids. Say the various type of fluids are the Newtonian fluids, non-Newtonian fluids, real fluids, ideal fluids. Then we have discussed the fluid properties. The important fluid properties are the mass density, then the specific weight, specific gravity, then the viscosity. So we have also discussed the Newton's law of viscosity, and we have derived the equation for the Newton's law of viscosity. That is, the Newton's law of viscosity is the tau, that is the shear stress, is equal to mu dv by dy. So this equation we have derived. That is, the shear stress is equal to mu. Mu is the dynamic viscosity of the fluid, and dv by dy is the velocity gradient or the change in velocity with respect to y. So this is called the Newton's law of viscosity. And next we have solved some two numerical problems based on the Newton's law of viscosity. Then in the today's class, we will discuss the remaining important properties of the liquid, that is the vapor pressure. Today we will discuss on vapor pressure. Then the second is compressibility and bulk modulus of liquid, that is K. Then the third is surface tension. Surface tension of liquid, and the fourth one is the capillarity. So these are the next properties. So the properties which we have already discussed in the earlier classes, that is the mass density, that is a very important property of the fluid, that is denoted by the symbol rho. Then the specific weight, that is the second important property, that is represented by the symbol w, small w. Then the specific gravity, then the specific volume. Then next is vapor pressure. What is this vapor pressure? Vapor pressure is that pressure the liquid changes from liquid state to gaseous state. Okay, vapor pressure is that pressure. On this pressure, or for this pressure, the liquid changes from the liquid state to gaseous state. Then how it happens? It is because of the continuous escape of molecules. Continuous escape of molecules. Liquid changes from the liquid state to gaseous state. So for example, you can take the water. Okay, when water is a fluid or it is a liquid. So when it is at the room temperature, it is in the state of liquid form only. So just you apply the heat, okay, beyond the room temperature, up to the certain limit, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 50 degrees, then the water starts boiling. So if you still applying the temperature, then you are getting some gas. Now it means that from certain limit, when the temperature exceeds that limit, then there is the process will take place. That is the molecules continuously escape. It means that the liquid, it is changing from liquid state to gaseous state. So that pressure is called the vapor pressure. Next is compressibility and bulk modulus of elasticity. That is the or bulk modulus of liquid, it is normally defined as the K. So compressibility is that property of the fluid or liquid, the when the external forces applied on the volume of liquid, it can be compressed. When the external forces are released, then the compressed volume of liquid will regain its original volume. That property is known as the compressibility. Okay, compressibility is that property of the fluid. So when external forces are applied, the volume of liquid can be compressed. When the external forces are released, then the liquid will regain its original compressed volume, or it is original volume, then that property is known as the compressibility. Then the modulus of bulk modulus of elasticity, K. So normally K is, it is the bulk modulus of elasticity, it is a constant. So this is equal to stress divided by strain. Stress divided by strain. So normally stress is what? It is the force divided by area, what we are studied in the solid mechanics. But in the fluid mechanics, we are normally using the pressure. Okay, that is the force divided by area. So it is known as the stress or the pressure. So change in pressure delta P divided by change in volume divided by original volume is strain. That is change in volume divided by original volume. Original volume, or you can call it is delta P minus delta dV by V. That is the change in volume divided by original volume. Okay, so this is the bulk modulus of elasticity. So normally we are taking this because when it is compressed, the volume will be in the compressed form. When it is released, it will be regain its original volume. That's why we are taking this negative sign. So bulk modulus of elasticity K, it is the constant. So this is nothing but change in pressure, that is the stress, divided by strain. Strain is what? Change in volume divided by original volume. So bulk modulus of elasticity of liquid K is delta P, that is the change in pressure divided by change in volume divided by original volume. That is, this is stress, this is the strain. Then the compressibility is defined as the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity. So compressibility is the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity, that is 1 by K. 1 by K is defined as the compressibility. Okay, so normally the K value for the air is K K value for a sorry for liquid for or the water is 2.06 into 10 raised to 9 Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square for water. For the numerical, for the analysis purpose, we are taking the bulk modulus of water. Bulk modulus of elasticity of water is 2.06 into 10 raised to 9 Newton per meter square. Okay, so bulk modulus of elasticity is what? It is the ratio of stress divided by strain. That is the change in pressure or pressure intensity divided by change in volume divided by original volume. So K is equal to delta P divided by change in volume divided by original volume. That gives you the bulk modulus of elasticity. Then the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity 1 by K is defined as the compressibility. Then the very next important property of the fluid is the surface tension. Is the surface tension. What is the surface tension? Surface tension, it is defined as, it has a tensile force. Surface tension is what? Surface tension is, or surface tension of a liquid is defined as, it is the tensile force acting on the surface of the liquid which is in contact with the air. Okay, surface tension is what? Surface tension is a tensile force, or surface tension of a liquid is defined as, it is a surface or it is a tensile force when the liquid is in contact with the free surface. What is free surface? So is what? See, suppose if I am taking a fluid in a container, okay, you can feel the water. You can feel the water. So this surface, it is called the free surface. Free surface, or the this surface, it is exposed to the atmospheric pressure. Means here the pressure is atmospheric pressure. Okay. So now what is the surface tension? Surface tension is a tensile force. Surface tension is a tensile force acting on the fluid surface or acting on the liquid surface which is in contact with the free surface. Free surface is what? It is the air. Okay, which is in contact with the air. Or the tensile force which is acting between the surfaces of two liquids having the different densities. Having the different densities on the surface of two liquids having the different densities. So let us take now the equation for the surface tension. Okay, how to derive the equation for the surface tension? So now first I will explain you what is the surface tension. So let us take a free surface. Let us take, this is the free surface of liquid or fluid. Okay, free surface of the liquid. So let us take a one liquid molecule here. Okay, it is a small liquid molecule, and okay, this is liquid molecule A. Liquid molecule A. Let us take this liquid molecule. So this molecule is attracted by the neighbor molecules in all the directions. Okay, so this liquid molecule A, it is attracting by neighboring molecules in all the directions. Hence, the net resultant force acting on this molecule is zero. The net resultant force acting on this molecule A is zero. Why? Because it is attracting by equal force in all the directions by the neighboring molecules. Now let us take another molecule on the free surface. Okay. On the free surface. Okay. This is the molecule which is lying on the free surface. Okay, so let us take, this is the center point of the molecule. These are the attractive forces. See here, in this molecule, the upward and the net upward and downward forces, attractive forces, are not same, are not equal. Hence, the resultant attractive force acts in the downward direction. Okay, in the downward direction. Similarly, you take another fluid, okay, which is in contact. So similarly here, this molecule also not in the equilibrium state. It is the net resultant force also acting on this molecule is in the downward direction. So on the free surface, then the molecules which are lying on the free surface, okay, which are lying on the free surface, are forming a thin film. Okay, that thin film is called membrane. Is called the membrane. Okay, a thin membrane is going to form on the top surface. Okay, so this phenomena is called the surface tension. So now the mathematical equation for this surface tension. Okay, it's clear. Surface tension is a tensile force acting on the surface of the liquid which is in contact with the air or which is at the free surface, or which surfaces between the two fluids having the different mass densities. Okay, so that is defined as the surface tension. Now, how to define a mathematical expression for the surface tension? So let us take a wall or a droplet. Okay, let us take the droplet. As I have told, let us take a droplet. Okay, so this droplet is attracting by all the neighboring molecules in equal magnitude in all the directions, attracting by external forces in all the directions. This molecule is in the equilibrium condition. Let us take a section or cut this droplet into two parts. Okay, left part and right part, that is called the halves. Okay, this is the left hull and this is the right hull. What I did is, I have taken one drop of liquid and I have taken a section. This is the section AA. This is my left hull and this is my right hull. So I have drawn here. So the whatever the surface tension or tensile force acting on this surface. On this surface, this is sigma. Surface tension is normally denoted by the sigma, and whatever pressure intensity is acting on this, this is the or the tensile force acting on this is on this surface is called the surface tensile force. And next is you take this and the force or the pressure intensity acting on this surface is because of this hole. Okay, that is the P. When these two are in combined, this droplet is in the equilibrium condition. Okay, now the when this droplet is in the equilibrium condition, so let us take the tensile force on this surface, on this tensile force due to surface tension, tensile force due to surface tension acting around the circumferential area of cut portion, okay, this is equal to what? This is equal to surface tension sigma multiplied by this length. Okay, that is the phi d, circumferential length divided by circumferential length phi d. D is what? Diameter of the droplet. Then phi multiplied by surface tension sigma. Okay, sigma into phi d gives you the tensile force acting on this circumferential area or the circumferential surface. Then the net pressure force acting on this surface, the net, let us call this is equation 1. Okay, then the pressure force, net pressure force acting on surface of cut portion, on the surface of cut portion means this is the cut portion, so this is the internal force, and this external force, because of you are getting this right hand side or the right wall, when these two are combined, this droplet is in the equilibrium condition. Okay, so now this is equal to what? Pressure intensity into area of the pi by 4 t square, area of the circumferential face. Okay, now for equilibrium condition equation 1 and 2, so you have sigma phi d, this is equal to pressure intensity P divided by phi by 4 d square, or the tensile stress or the shear surface tension P. So this phi cancels. So P divided by 4 into D, or P is equal to 4 sigma divided by D. 4 sigma divided by D. So this is the equation for the pressure intensity or pressure inside the droplet. Pressure inside the droplet is 4 sigma. Sigma is what? This is the surface tension of the fluid. So it is Newton per meter divided by D is the diameter of the droplet. So the pressure intensity inside a droplet is equal to P divided by P is equal to pressure intensity equal to 4 sigma divided by D. P is the small p is the pressure intensity inside the droplet. Sigma is the surface tension divided by D. So this is the relation between P and sigma. That is the pressure intensity and the surface tension. See, you observe this. Okay, you observe this mathematical equation. What it tells? Okay, as the diameter d, okay, surface tension of any fluid is same, okay, or it is constant. P is inversely proportional to 1 by d. P is, that is the pressure intensity inside a droplet, is inversely proportional to 1 by d. It means what? If pressure intensity inside the droplet increases, the diameter decreases. Or in other words, if the diameter d of the droplet decreases, the pressure intensity inside the droplet P will be increases. So this is the important physical conclusion. Okay, physical conclusion. So the application we will discuss later on. This is what physical conclusion. You take a droplet of a liquid, okay, as the diameter of the droplet decreases, the pressure intensity inside the droplet will increases. Okay, so let us take a bubble. A bubble droplet or a soap bubble droplet. A soap bubble droplet. Okay, or a hollow. So soap bubble droplet means a hollow bubble droplet. Or the soap bubble droplet is P is equal to 8 sigma divided by D. This is for the soap droplet. Okay, these are the important relations. Or you can soap bubble. You can also call as the soap bubble. So a hollow bubble or a soap bubble, the pressure intensity inside a hollow bubble or soap bubble is 8 sigma divided by D. Okay, so this is another important property of the fluid. So the next we will discuss is what? Capillarity. Okay, so capillarity. See, students, we are going to upload all these notes, okay, after the end of the discussion. Okay, still the discussion may take another 3 or 4 classes. Then in the next class, we will see the pressure, variation of pressure, and how to measure the liquid pressure. Okay, so still we are discussing on the properties of the fluids. So this is one of the property of the surface tension. So the next one is capillarity. Okay, capillarity. Capillarity. Okay, what is the capillarity? Capillarity is the phenomena of liquid, or capillarity is what? It is that property of the fluid, or it is a phenomena when a glass tube is immersed in a liquid. So the liquid inside the glass tube may rise or may fall. Okay, so let us take a liquid in a container, liquid in the container, and it is filled with a fluid or liquid. Okay, filled with a liquid. Let us immerse a glass tube. Let us immerse a glass tube on this. Okay. Then capillarity is what? It is the phenomena, or it is that property of the liquid. Because of this property, the liquid inside the tube may rise. May rise. So this is the rise H, or if you are take another, okay. This is filled with a fluid. This is a glass tube is immersed. The fluid inside the tube may fall. Okay, this is the H. This is H is the fall of liquid inside the glass tube. Inside the glass tube. And this is the rise of liquid inside the glass tube. Rise of liquid inside the glass tube. So capillarity is now how it is defined. It is the that property of the fluid, or it is that phenomena when a glass tube is immersed in a liquid. The liquid may rise in the glass tube, or it may fall in the glass tube. So this phenomena is called the capillarity. Okay, what is the best example? That is the practical example. See, you can observe the plants and trees. How the plants and trees, they takes water and food from the soil because of this capillarity action. So this is, okay, this is the example. The how the plants or trees, they will take water and food for their survival. They will take the soil and water from the soil, plant or trees from the soil, because of this capillarity action. So capillarity action, or capillarity is that property of the fluid, or that phenomena when a glass tube is immersed in a liquid. The liquid may rise in the glass tube, may fall in the glass tube. So this rise or fall of liquid inside the glass tube is called capillarity, or the liquid property capillarity. So the best practical example, how the plants and trees, they will absorb water and food or the required nutrients from the soil because of this property of the liquid. So we will stop this class here. In the next class we will discuss the mathematical derivations for the capillarity action, that is the rise in liquid inside the glass tube, fall of the liquid inside the glass tube. We will solve or we will derive two mathematical equations for these two phenomena, and then we will discuss the pressure intensity of a fluid and how to measure the pressure intensity of fluid. So after the end of this first module, we are going to upload the notes and also some of the numerical problems. So one numerical problem, say let us take this on the surface tension. Pressure, okay, let us, I am going to read this problem. So of course it is also going to upload. The pressure outside the droplet of water of diameter 0.0 mm is 10.32 Newton per centimeter square, that is atmospheric pressure. Calculate pressure within the droplet if surface tension is 0.0725. Okay, so here what are the things in this problem? Diameter of droplet, okay, this is the droplet, D is given, that is the 0.04 mm, or it is equal to 0.04 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Okay, then the surface tension is given, surface 10.32 Newton per centimeter square, or it is 10.32 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per meter square. Okay, now what is the pressure intensity inside the droplet? P is equal to 4 sigma divided by D. 4 sigma is 10.32 into 10 raised to 4 divided by D is 0.04 into 10 raised to minus 3, or P is equal to, you calculate this, P you are getting 7250 Newton per meter square, or it is 0.725 Newton per centimeter square. Okay, so like this some numerical examples may ask in the examination. So all this problem will be also uploaded along with your notes. You please go through that. So next class we will discuss or we will derive numerical mathematical expression for the rise of liquid inside the glass tube for the capillarity phenomena and fall of the liquid inside the glass tube. Okay, so after that we will discuss the pressure, pressure intensity, variation of pressure inside the fluid or on the fluid, then the measurement of pressure. Okay, so we will end this session here.